So in this video, we shall learn about the knapsack problem using dynamic programming. Okay. So please recall that you have already solved the knapsack problem using the greedy approach, isn't it? Okay. So where you go on selecting, you will build a subset of the given set of items that will maximize the overall profit that is gained. Okay. So similarly, here also you will have to solve the same knapsack problem. So here there are some four items, and the weights of those items are given, and values of these items are given. So in the greedy approach, we have used profit, profit of each of the item. So here we use value as the word. Okay, all right. Now, this knapsack problem is also called as the 0-1 knapsack. Okay, 0-1 knapsack. Okay, why? Because we either include or exclude an item. Okay, so please recall, in the greedy approach to the knapsack, we included partial weights of the items, and hence we consider the partial profits. But in 0-1 knapsack, there are no partial items that should be included. It is only whether the item is included or not, and hence it is called as the 0-1 knapsack. All right, so this will be apparent finally when we write the solution. Okay, all right. Next, so we shall now start solving the knapsack problem using dynamic approach. Okay, so as we know, the using dynamic programming as the strategy, at each stage we take the decision. It is a series of decisions. Okay, and we finally come up with the solution by constructing a table, isn't it? So similarly, in this problem also, we first construct the table. Okay, so let us see how this table looks like. Okay, so now see here, what is the maximum capacity of the knapsack? It is 5. Okay, the maximum capacity of the knapsack is 5, and how many items are there? 4. Therefore, you will have to draw a table where the columns consist of each of the capacity starting from 0 to 5. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next, how many items are there? 4. Therefore, you have to start with 0 till 4. Okay, so it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fine. So just for simplicity, I will write these values. I will just rewrite these values here. Each of the weights wi and each of the value vi. Okay, so vi wi, I will go on writing here. So 2 1 3 2, and the values are 12 10 20 and 15. Okay, fine. So now what this table indicates? So this table says that when you are including the zeroth item and the knapsack capacity is 0, how many items you can fill? So when the knapsack capacity itself is 0, you cannot fill any of the items, isn't it? Therefore, all these becomes 0. Similarly, okay, when you consider the first item, and if the capacity of the knapsack is 0, you are going to fill none of the items, isn't it? So that is why it is also 0. Similarly, here also 0, here also 0, here also 0. Okay, and that is why in this table you can see that the first row and the first columns gets filled with 0. Why? Because when the capacity of the knapsack is 0, this given capacity, it is 5. So when I consider capacity as 0, how many items you can fill? None of the items. That is the meaning of filling all the columns as 0. Now, when you are considering the 0th item, right, which capacity you can fill? None of the capacity, and hence it is all zeros. Okay, all right. Now, So now we shall see how to exactly fill the table. Okay. All right. So consider the first item. Where is the first item? Here is the first item. Okay. So what is the weight of the first item? You can see the weight of the first item is 2. Okay. Therefore, if at all I am including this item into the knapsack, right, the capacity of 2 gets filled, isn't it? Therefore, in the column 2, so the column indicates the weights. I will call this as J, okay, and I will call this as I, okay, and all these are, this is what the W, maximum capacity, okay. Therefore, if at all I am considering only one item, I will be able to fill the 2 capacity. And if at all I am able to fill the capacity with 2, what is the profit I gain? What is the value I am going to earn is 12. Therefore, you have to fill 12 here. Okay, 12 here. All right. Next. What about the previous? What about the previous? You just written the 0 as it is. Next, here, even though capacity of the knapsack is 3 and you are allowed to fill only one item, you are still able to include only one item and the profit that is gained is only 12. Okay. Next, consider the 2 items. Okay. Now, I will include this item into my set of items. Therefore, I have 2 items currently, in the set I have considered. Okay. So now when I consider the second element, the second item, what is the weight of the second item? 1. Therefore, if at all the capacity of, knapsack is 1, then I will be directly able to fill this item and the profit or the value that I able to earn is 10. Okay. Now, in the dynamic, knapsack using dynamic programming, when you are considering the second item, you should also consider the total weights. You also consider the total weights. Now, so I have considered the second item and I filled it at the weight 1. Now, since in my set there are 2 items, you have to combinedly select these 2. When I combinedly select these 2, what is the total weight? 3. Whether column 3 is there? Yes, column 3 is there. Okay, we are not exceeding the total capacity. When column 3 I am able to fill, I have to consider both the items. If I am considering both the items, what is the total profit gain now? It is 10 plus 12. So 22 I will have to fill. 22. Okay, so currently I have 2 items. I can fill, 22, I can get the maximum as the 22 profit. Okay, next, what about this entry? So this entry has to be filled by the maximum of either this value or this value. Okay, since we have 12 as the maximum, written 12. Okay, next, what about this? Given the capacity of the knapsack 4 and given only these 2 items, you are still able to fill only these 2 items. You are able to obtain only the profit of 10 plus 12, 22. And hence 22 in the remaining boxes. Next, consider the third item. Okay, when I consider the third item, now I have 3 items currently I have considered. Therefore, you have to consider weight of the third item and then another combination weight of the third item and weight of the first item, another combination weight of the third item and weight of the second item. So weight of the third item is 3. So at 3, what is the profit I am able to get? 20. But is there any already maximum profit? Yes, there is already a maximum profit, 22. Therefore, you will have to retain this 22 as it is. Okay, because we have to earn the maximum profit. Therefore, in the previous row, if there is any maximum value, you have to retain as it is. Done? Next. Consider the third and first item. What is the total weight? 3 plus 2, 5. So 5 is there. Yes, the column 5 is there. And what is the total profit? 20 plus 10. It is 32. So of course, 32 is higher value. I will fill it up. Next, 3 plus 1. 4. So column 4, and what is the total profit? 30. So here 22 is there, therefore I will be I can write 30 here. Done. What about these remaining? So just copy them as it is. Copy them as it is. Okay, right. Next, consider the fourth item. When I consider the fourth item, what is the weight of this item? 2. Right, at 2, what is the profit? 15. What is the previous profit? It is 12. Therefore, I have to refill it, fill it by 15. Next, consider the fourth and first item. 2 plus 2, 4. So, at capacity 4, 15 plus 12, it is 27. But already we have 30 here. Therefore, retain 30 as it is. Done. Next, the fourth item and the second item. 2 plus 1, 3. So, at 3, what is the profit? It is 25. So, here 22. Therefore, I will be able to rewrite it as 25. Next. This fourth and third item. So, 3 plus 2, 5. 3 plus 2, 5. And, as you can see, it is 20 plus 15, 35. 35. We also have one more combination. See here. 3 plus 2 plus 1. How much? It is 3 plus 2 plus 1, it is 6. So that 6 capacity is not there. Leave it off. Next we have fourth item, the first item and the second item. So 2 plus 2 plus 1. How much? It is 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5. So 5 is there. Now 15 plus 10, 12 plus 10, how much? It is 37. So 37 is the maximum value. So I will be able to fill 37 here. So similarly, check with this along with these two. You check this along with these two, this along with these two entries. So all the combinations you will have to try out. Okay. So rather than trying out this combination, we have a formula. Okay, we will see that. All right. So now this remains as it is and fill the 10 as it is. Okay. So this is how you have to fill the knapsack table. Now I will write the formula so that you can better understand the formula. Now the formula goes like this. Let us call this entire table as capital V. Okay, capital V. So it is capital V of I comma j equals maximum of V of I minus 1 comma j I minus 1 comma j comma V I plus V of I minus 1 comma j minus WI. Okay, WI. So this is if j minus WI is greater than or equal to 0. Otherwise it is just V of I minus 1 comma j if j minus WI is less than 0. So we shall apply this formula for some of the entries now. Okay. All right. So now just see, I will just randomly select any one. So let us call 2, 3. Okay. So V of 2, 3. V of 2, 3. So V of 2, 3 is nothing but maximum of so. See here, in this case, V of 2, 3. So this is I and this is J. What is the J value? J value is 3. And what is the current WI? So weight of the second atom. So weight of the second atom is 1. Okay. And what is 3 minus 1? It is 2. Okay. Right. So 3 minus 1, it is 2. So therefore, we have to apply 3 minus 1 greater than or equal to 0. So we have to apply this formula. So it is maximum of v of I minus 1, I mean in the previous row. So v of, you know, it is 1 comma 3 comma the profit of the current item, that is vi, the second item profit is 10 plus v of I minus 1, that is 1 comma j minus wi, j is 3 and wi is 1, so it is 2. Okay, see, v of 1 comma 3, v of 1 comma 1 comma 3 is 12 comma 10 plus v of 1 comma 2, v of 1 comma 2 is 12. So 12 and 22, which is the larger value? 22. And hence in v of 2 comma 3, 22 gets filled. Okay, all right. Next we shall consider one more. If I have to fill v of 3 comma 1, okay, I value is 3, j value is 1. Okay, so third item, so what is the weight of the third item? Weight of the third item is 3, and value of the third item is 20. Okay, what is j minus wi? See here, j minus wi, j is 1, wi is 3, how much? Minus 2. So minus 2, we don't have any minus 2 entry is invalid, isn't it? The value minus 2 is invalid, and hence you just retain the previous value. So v of I minus 1 comma j, so v of 2 comma 1, what do you mean? So v of 3 comma 1 is nothing, just nothing but v of 2 comma 1. So v of 3 comma 1 is nothing but v of 2 comma 1. Why? Because we don't have any entry called as minus 2. Okay, and that is why in the formula, as you can see, when you consider the third item, the capacity you should consider at least 3. So weight of the third item is 3, so the capacity should be at least 3. So if at all it is not 3, the remaining items, so you have to fill as it is. That is why it is v of i minus 1 comma j. Okay, all right. Now in order to better understand filling up of this table, you apply the same formula to constructing the entire table, so that it will be now you can better understand these terms, why it is vi, why it is v of I minus 1 comma j minus wi. Okay, so in order to better understand these terms, you have to construct the entire table using this formula. Okay, all right, done. Now, so the story does not end here. We have one more thing to be done. Okay, so which items to be included and which items not to be included in the knapsack. Okay, so I will write this as x1, x2, x3, x4. So please recall in the solution whether I have to include the first item, second item, third item, fourth item. In the greedy method, we used to write something like 0, then 0.25, then 1, 0, something like this, isn't it? We have to include fullest of the third item, we have to include only 25% of the second item, like that. So here, how to fill that? How to get the optimal solution? Now see here, in order to fill this, you have to start with the last row, the fourth item. Okay, so in the fourth item, in the last row, which is the maximum value? 37. Okay, 37. How did you obtain that 37? It is v of 4 comma 5. V of 4 comma 5, isn't it? Now just check whether it is equal to v of 3 comma 5. What is v of 3 comma 5? 32, right? So this is not equal to v of 3 comma 5. What do you mean by this? This means that the 37 is contributed by including this item, that is the fourth item. Okay, and hence
you have to have the fourth atom in the optimal set, and hence X4 has to be made 1. Next, when you make X4 into the knapsack, what is the weight of the fourth atom? It is 2. Weight of the fourth atom is 2. Therefore, in the knapsack, overall capacity 5, you have to perform minus 2. What is this 2? This 2 is nothing but the weight of the fourth atom. Why have to perform minus? Why? Because we have included fourth atom into the knapsack. Okay. Therefore, we are remaining with the capacity 3. Now we have to check how this capacity 3 is filled by which all atoms. Okay. So for that, what you have to see is V of 4, 3 now. Okay. V of 4, 3. So currently you are in the V of 4, 5. So we have to check whether it is V of 4, 3. Just see V of 4, 3. What is the value? 30. Now you have already included the fourth atom. So now you have to check V of 3, 3. Why V of 3, 3? This 3 indicates the item. So we have considered the fourth atom. Now we have to check with the third atom. Next, second, next one, first. And what is this 3? It is the remaining capacity. Remaining capacity. Therefore, you have to look at 3, 3. What is 3, 3? It is 22. Now, just check whether it is equal to V of 2, 3. V of 2, 3, it is also 22. Yes. Once again, check whether it is V of 1, 3. Is it equal to V of 1, 3? No. Right? Therefore, this value 22 is contributed by including the second item into the knapsack, not the third. So, 22, you have to go back. So, 22 and this is 12. Therefore, this is the item. Second is the item you should include in the knapsack. Therefore, in the solution, so X2 has to be made 1 and X3 0, because X3 were not included. Done. Next, out of the remaining capacity 3, the item 2 has contributed a weight of 1. Item 2 has contributed a weight of 1. Therefore, the remaining capacity is 2. Remaining capacity is 2. Now you have to check whether V of, so we have done with the second atom, come back to the first atom. So 1, 2. What is V of 1, 2? It is 12. Just check whether it is V of 0, 2. What is V of 0, 2? It is 0. So it is not equal. Therefore, you have to include the first item into the list. You have to include first item into the knapsack. Done, and we are done with this, and the optimal solution is x1 x2 x3 x4 is given by 1 1 0 1. What does it mean? You have to include the first, second and the fourth atom into the knapsack so that we get the maximum profit. Okay, so this is the solution.